Honestly. For real, for real.
Yo, Triple P, keep pulling, man.
Yeah. Honestly.
You outside the box for sure. You gonna fuck around and catch on. Everybody gonna be talking about some motherfucker, honestly. Shit can go crazy. No time. Shut up. One time, Triple P, let him hear it, man. Woo! So what did y'all get from that? I said, mom is a negative Nancy. Honestly. Did she get you $50 for real?
Yeah, it's real money.
Get the fuck out of here. Triple P is rich. I got money, but I wouldn't give you a fucking quarter. I got a pocket full of money. I promise you I'm never give you nothing. He's still counting too, he's like, yeah, 38, 39, 40. Hey, that's one way to rent a fan, though. Are you a fan
now?
What's his name?
Triple P.
And what's his social media?
He did give me a card, yeah.
Fucking say thank you,
that's
man.
That's Majestic 12. That's Majestic 12, yeah.
Say thank you.
And thank you.
Right here.
Thank you, man. Thank you.
Well done, Triple P. Give it up, Triple P, y'all. And he got a girlfriend on there. Triple P getting pussy and everything, man. You gotta respect that. Thank you, Miss D. Did D fuck up the video?
Yeah.
She got it right. But the last time she fucked it up, did you remember right, Pete?
Yeah.
Hey, you know what? The only thing I'll give you a note, just comment to comment. Whenever you get on the floor, make sure that shit kill. Cause it's hard to get up when that shit don't. You be like, you be on the floor, they're like, God damn it. I used to do a lot of shit that I ended up on the floor, and I remember getting back up, be a long day. Shit. Don't get mad at your dad for leaving your mom, cause you don't know her. Say it again. Don't get mad at your dad for leaving your mom because you don't know. You know your mother, but you don't know his girlfriend. Oh. Yeah, she can cook now after 50 years. He had to take all her first dishes. She was having trouble. And how about this? Maybe he did you a favor by not being there. Maybe this deadbeat guy did you a favor by not being there. Think about it. Some of our fathers are horrible people. If this guy would have raised you, you could have been exactly as fucked up as him. I'll give you a great example. LeBron James, you never hear about his father, but the man had a father. He has a father. His father is still walking around. I'm in Akron, Ohio. I'm at a barbershop. I'm like, where's LeBron's dad? They said, oh, his dad is blah, blah. They told me where the man was. And they told me a story how LeBron was raised by the men in the community. They stopped and they gave him the game of basketball. And they trained him how to be a great human being. And LeBron James benefited from not being raised by this man. That man, LeBron's father, was a pimp. If he raised LeBron, we would have a whole different guy. We wouldn't have no world-renowned basketball player. Have a big-ass pimp that can slap bitches from across the room. Pop! Watch yourself, bitch. Sorry, bro. You know what? I feel like that merited way more laughter than y'all gave. I really do. I was deep in that whole scenario. Y'all.
But the audience never lies.
I once heard Arsenio Hall say, it's never the audience. It's always something you can do as a comedian to make the joke better. You know, sometimes it's actually y'all, but it's... But it's not y'all. As much as it's you, it's not you. Me as a professional is something that I can do to make the situation better. But sometimes y'all as an audience don't belong together. Like, look at this group of people. Like, yeah, three cousins, little old school relationship, young people, titties, co-workers, Tinder. Co-worker, that's it, cool. We don't know what the hell they doing over there. I hate this night already. I want to go. Damn, God, put me through this shit. All right, let's see. Grab the neck.
I just saw that note. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I'm looking forward to seeing this young man. We was talking in the back. I just met him for the first time tonight. Y'all gonna love him. Show some love for Sam P. Y'all.
Sam P.
Say jungle. Fuck me up with that one. I went to one time and he showed his head and goes, oh, young nigga. So, okay. I'ma roll with that. I'm about to beat your whole young ass. For real, for real. I like that, man. Trip. Trip P.
Right here.
Fuck, it don't matter. How y'all doing today, man? I'm Sam P, man. I'm out of Dallas, Texas. And I didn't know I was coming up, so I'm just finna just take this thing out there, you know what I'm saying? Okay, here we go. Y'all got homeless people out here, I noticed. They make themselves known. Man, we had went to this little place, Trip took me to, he had been there before, and I come out, homeless dude come to me and say, hey man, let me have $7. I said, $7? We're gonna have the 50 cent dollar. I said, there's some real homeless people out here. I said, I need to take your job. I sell two an hour, that'd be minimum wage, won't it? Give me two people, give me seven apiece. Okay. But I heard somebody out here say, what y'all say, y'all was colleagues? That's a good one, man. I like that. When I got busted cheating, I should have told them, that wasn't my girl, that was a colleague. And that is a Rosh Buko. That is a Rosh Buko, ain't it? You know, y'all don't know what a Rosh Buko is. Cosby Show. Lisa Bonet made it for Theo, right?
Yes, sir.
That motherfucker original, too. I like that motherfucker. But anyway, how many of y'all got kids? I pretty much know all of y'all got kids, but y'all not with y'all wives and husbands in here. This shit is all a big hookup. Colleagues. I might get some pussy tonight. But you said you getting some pussy tonight. That's some real shit. That's all the way 1,000. And y'all, it don't matter if he getting on or not. After 20 years, the baby 20, right? I'm sure it's hit. I don't know these days. But you know, she a baby, right? See, you don't know. Those that know don't tell. Those that tell don't know. But yeah, man, I got
Huh? Got you,
24, 22. Oh, right on. That's what's up. She said, hey, 20 though. Right. Oh, okay. You never know. But yeah, man, I got a couple myself, man. Got one that's 30. See why he said young man? My son, 30. Wow. You can tell by the hairline. But check this out. when they got there, I try. I'm holding on. I'm keeping mine. They said, let it go. I said, I'm keeping mine because they're going to come in with something that I can afford. Miles and I can't fuck with that right now. I got credit card bills. I can't fuck with Visor right now, but I'm working on it. But yeah, I got a 30-year-old man, and it was something growing, raising him and shit, you know. And I took him to 5 different colleges, man. I tried him out 5 different times, man, because I didn't want him to go to 5. It's better 5 colleges than 5 prisons. You understand what I'm saying? So we all up the. It ain't probably that kind of coast, but we all up the South Coast. You know, we Grambling Prairie, we had all this shit, trying to keep him in school, man. Finally, that last time I took him to Jackson, that before Dion's. I told you I was kind of over. He finally told me, I dropped him off in August, he was back in October. Before Halloween. They don't have no vacation for Halloween. Why are you here? He told me school wasn't for him. So he started rapping. Now, we lived in some of our better urban communities, but he hadn't been there in about 10 or 15 years. So he's trying to rap, and I told him, after I listened to him, I said, hey man, you've been out the hood for about 15 years. You don't have it. What you are doing is a hobby. You just practicing. So we were sitting up talking. He says, say, Daddy, he said, ain't you still doing that comedy? I said, yeah, I'm doing comedy. He said, you getting paid for it? I said, well, not right now, man. It's coming through. He said, I ain't trying to be funny, but,
you don't have it.
Say, my boy, that ain't nothing but a hobby. So, yeah, bottom line, man. I got a 15-year-old, too. See, I started over. See, sometimes the shit just don't go right. We got Daddy. I had to start over. I'm going to put you on child support. I don't care. My daughter make more than I do. Not real. And I know, you know, growing up, I know y'all done did this. I know in school, everybody, this is just some like routine shit. That teacher told you all that you all can be anything that you all wanted to be. And I know some of y'all believed that shit. I believed it too. I said, she asked me, I said, I wanted to be an attorney. She kind of laughed a little bit. She said, Sam, you can be it. Man, I'm pushing 50 and I'm an inventory clerk. Think she lied. But my 15-year-old, she got into it. I don't know how kids make a straight A's, but the teacher's calling home saying they ain't going to school. I don't know what's going on with that. So I was telling her, hey, look, you got to go to school if you want to be somewhere. My son said, Sammy didn't do anything. I'm talking about my son. Now I said, well, you need to do something. You got to be something in this life. She said, well, actually, I got a job making more than you. I don't realize. I said, hey, watch your mouth. But that's kids, man. 2023 kids. Man, I'm going to let y'all go, man. I'm going to just let y'all go with this here. It is what it is. We all got daddies. That don't mean they're about shit. But we all got one. We all have one, right?
Yep.
I had one. My daddy was a pimp. I seen him 17 times in my life. That's once a year on Christmas. And I think he was just showing off. He always bring these girls over and say they were our sisters. Because they always call them daddy. I was and one day he brought me a Michael Jackson jacket for Christmas. You know, I told you I go way back. I go way back. And man, I wore that jacket to school because of a cold. At first, I didn't want to wear it. I wore that jacket to school, man, and I was a star. They counted my zippers. I had all 21. You know, that's a real Michael Jackson jacket. So they done started me up. You know, my mama was an usher. You know, the ones that, you know, and she had these white gloves. All I needed was that glove. That's all I needed. Mama had them white gloves. She keep them sparkling white. And I stole one of them gloves. And I got like glitter and they glue from school, from art class. And I was in the room putting that glue on there. She busted it. Boy, I've been looking for the goddamn glue. Give me my guy. That's my time, man. Sit up to you.